Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Revit's Global Knowledge. So as I promised on my previous tutorial, I got talking about how to create those kind of facade design there, and I will show you the quick way to create this awning here. But before I proceed that, I will introduce you how to place those window, because I know some of my subscribers, they don't know yet how to place the window here. Basically, I will give you a quick tip to create and apply those window there. I just call out. Basically, you just create your wall there, and after that you adjustment your wall for 2 meter by 2 meter, same as your facade design here. Only you placing your window, and you can adjustment your window from there. It's a parametric. This is a quick way how you can create your window there, and I will give you a quick instruction about that. So let's say I will select here, then I'm going to copy, I will move it out. So if you want to know how to create the awning, you can skip a couple of minutes for this tutorial, because this tutorial is continued from our past one. And if you want to create those kind of facade design, you want to know that, you just take a look on my previous tutorial. Okay, so I will hit I for height element. So what I'm going to do next is my facade design there. It's a basic generic model that we modeled before in our previous tutorial. So I'm going to start from the top here, then WA on my keyboard for wall. I will start here, just make it like this. As you can see here, hit escape a couple time. Then I will start from the front here. I will start from front here like this. Then I will adjustment my wall here is 2 meter, as you can see here. And let's go over there, readjustment as well. As you can see here, so now it's perfect. Our wall is fit with our facade. So it's the very first one. You just go in your window, WN on my keyboard for window. Then here is my window. As you can see here, I have load one. And of course, if you want your window is fit with your here, you need to go to the tie. And of course, you need to adjustment here is a width and height. And the window there, you need to load from your family library. This is the window that I load one, and I have adjustment. I will give you a quick one. Adjust it okay. Then we start from front like this, and I will just simply place here like this one. Hit escape a couple times. As you can see here, it's quite fast and quite nice for this for our window. And this guy over there, I can adjustment my wall here until I got what I want. I can adjustment here until my window here like this, and I can adjustment more. In some cases, I don't want to show my wall. You can hide your wall by right click on your cursor, then hide an element, as you can see here. So now your window is aligned with your facade. This is how you can place the window on your facade design from my previous tutorial. So look back on our awning. I will HR for revert back my element, and this guy over there, I will delete a show. Okay, so once I done that, I will be select all of them like this. Or I can select one of them, SA for select all instance. Then I'm going to VHEG for hidden element, and our steel plate as well, select here like this. Then VHEG, then I can SA for select all element first, SA for select all element, then VHEG for hidden all. Now it's time to create our awning here. It's a quick way to apply like this. Basically, as you can see here, we got our glass, or we can using polycarbonate in this kind of situation, and we got our bin system is running properly. It's coming combination with our beam here, as you can see here. So how could you do that? I will show you. So I will be delete here first. Okay, and this guy you delete also, SA, then we have basically here, you could see here I got my steel plate, but I got high already. So I'm going to create my awning here. Start from top view, then go to our architecture tab, go to rules by footprint. Okay, we could not operation on 3D view, so you might be need to go to your site plan. And I'm going to select SAL for high element first. SA. And this guy over there, SA again. I'm going to hide element first. Okay, it's time to get our awning. I'm going to our architecture tab, go to our roofs by footprint. It's yes. This is just a quick tip, and then I'm going to change it for slope glassy. Then I will try to use a pick line, just pick here like this. Then I'm going to draw it out, just draw it out like this until here. And of course, I will select all of them. Then I can define slope. Okay, so I'm going to use our filter here. Select our filter, radium, make it for 2 meter. Hit escape a couple of times. For the radian here, I will define slope for antique as well. And of course, I can go to my property panel. Then I will adjustment for here, just make it for 300. It's a default that I have set up before. Basically, when you're coming, it's like this. So what you need to do, you just change from none to fixed distance and type out for 300. Hit apply, then it's okay. Once you've done that, you just hit finish out. Let me see. Because here you now haven't connected yet, that's why we got some problem. So I'm going to trim and extend like this. Then I just hit finish. Once I done that, I just go to my architecture tab there. Go to my mullion. I just apply all grid. Select like this. Hit escape a couple of times. As you can see here, go to our 3D. Then I will turn it up like this. As you can see here, it's quite fast and quite nice. It's running properly for our awning design in our building tutorial. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for the tutorial. I hope you got learn something new about that. And before I finish up, I will show you some more tip. I just like here, the reason we could not see our vertical mullion here, because I for create tool I never turn on it. I turn on, will be see another one apply. So far will be too heavy. Basically, so far will be generating. Okay, as you can see here, so I can go to architecture tab, then go to mullion. I just apply all like this. Come on. Okay, hit escape a couple of times. As you can see here, it's quite nice and quite realistic. You want to create some kind of buffer ceiling, just zoom out your curtain panel and combination with your mullion is also can. As you can see here, it I turn on for realistic. Okay, it's quite nice for our design. I got my previous tutorial on create this facade. I got on my previous tutorial on create those kind of facade also. Now is the part 2 to add our awning and press our window. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial. Thank you for joining me from start to finish. Thank you for watching, and I see you for another tutorial in Revit. And make sure thumbs up, like and share, and subscribe if you are first time reaching out here. Thank you again for watching. I see you for another tutorial in Revit, and have a nice day. Thank you.